Dear students, you are welcome to another important discussion in accounting modeling. Today we are going to discuss spreadsheet decision logic. Let's have a look at our lesson outline. In this section, we are going to talk about Boolean operators and basic if functions and some applications of advanced if functions to accommodate a complicated logical decision scenarios. So we'll first look at what is meant by Boolean operators. The concept of Boolean operators or Boolean logical expressions or Boolean algebra was invented by a very popular or great mathematician called George Boole. He's a mathematician and a philosopher. We'll have a look at some basic applications of Boolean operators that are popularly applied in computing or in Excel spreadsheet logical test. So Boolean operators can be used to express a conditional logics. For example, if you want to test whether a particular value is equal to another value, then you can express it's like A equals to B. That means you are going to test whether A is equal to B or not. If this condition satisfied, you will receive the result as true. If it's not satisfied, your result will be false. Let's say if you want to test whether value A is not equal to value B, you can write this particular expression in your formula. You can incorporate this logical expression into your Excel formula, then Excel will test whether value A is not equal to value B. If it's not equal to value B, you will receive a result true, otherwise false. Then the third expression can be used if you want to test whether value A or any value referred to a cell represented by, let's say, symbol A, whether A value is less than that of B. If this condition satisfied, Excel gives you result true. If it is not satisfied, result will be false. So accordingly, these are the some of the popular logical expressions, which these are called Boolean logical expressions. If you want to, let's say, test whether a particular value, let's say value A is less than or equal to value B, then you can use this particular logical expression. At the same time, the last logical expression can be applied if you want to test as to whether value A or value A that is appeared in a particular cell is greater than or equal to another value, let's say value B. It can be expressed like this. So we will now see how these Boolean operators can be applied in Excel. Right, I have developed a simple model so that you can with this simple model you can see how these Boolean operators can be applied. Let's try equal sign. Let's say we want to test whether this employee's outcome, I'll give an introduction about the nature of these inputs. Right, in this input area, you can see you have been given about the daily employee's daily wage rate. Let's say employee's daily basic wage rate is $100 and a bonus is $10. Employees are entitled to receive $10 bonus. Let's say if and only if their daily output is equal or greater than 50 units, right? So according to employees whose output is greater than or equal to 50 units, they are entitled to receive this $10 bonus, right? So this is the scenario, and you are given the information about the names of the employees and the actual performance in terms of unit produced, right? Okay, then let's say we want to test whether employees output is exactly equal to 50. How we can start? We can first type equal sign to say that we are going to write a formula. So this equal sign is used in Excel to say that you are going to write a formula. Then what you want to ensure whether this output level is equal to 50. Now this equal sign is a part of your Boolean operation, right? So you, accordingly you can see C5 cell equal to 50. This is what we are going to test. We are going to test whether value appeared in the C5 cell, whether it is equal to 50 or not. So the according to this Boolean operation, we will see the result. You can see result is false. Why? Because condition is not satisfied. Our condition, we wanted to test whether this cell value is equal 50. No, it is not equal 50. So result is false. So you can just copy this to other employees. So these are results. Second, you can see only the person called Aaron got his actual output is 50. So accordingly, this condition satisfies only with Aaron. For all other employees, condition is not satisfied, right? So let's see how we can apply this to another condition. Let's assume we want to test whether this employee's output, right, is not equal to 50. So you can just write it like this. So this is a part of Boolean operation, right? A not equal to B. Here A reference number, cell number is C5, and this is the symbol that is used in Boolean operations. Then this is the value we substitute for B symbol, right? So we'll test. It is true. Why? We want to test whether this cell C5, whether it's not equal to 50. Yes, C5 cell value is 65. It is not equal to 60. Answer is true. Then we can apply it to other cells. So you can see with respect to only Aaron, cell value is not equal to 50. So he got false. For all other employees, result is true. Let's see another Boolean operation. Let's say we want to ensure whether the cell value is greater than 50. Greater than 50. So you just start typing equal sign. It's not a part of your Boolean operation. It's just to say your Excel, you are writing a formula. Then this is your Boolean expression, Boolean operator. C5 is greater than 50. Just enter. Yes, it is greater than 50. So true. And you can see whether it's applicable for others. Right. So like this, you can simply apply this logical condition and you can get the result. Let's say we want to ensure whether the employee's output, whether it is greater than or equal to 50, greater than or equal 50. Then you just type it like this and enter. Here this equal or greater than 50, true. And you can apply it like this. Then you can see even right the person who got 50 is true. Why? Greater than or equal. This time this true because it's equal 50. For this denial, he got true because it's greater than 50. Right? For all other people not achieved 50 or below 50, they got result false. Right. Now there's another important and interesting thing with respect to this result. In Boolean operations, logical condition, we get the result either true or false. And the interesting thing for this true and false has a numerical value. Unlike other words that you type in Excel, this true and false has a numerical value. We will see what is the numerical value assigned to this true. Usually, for true, we have a standard numerical value that is 1. And for false, we have a standard numerical value equal to 0. How we can ensure? You know, when you add 0 to any value, you get the original value. So we'll see. We will add true with 0. You can see answer is 1. and then you can just copy this to others. Then you can see, right, for true you have value of 1, for false value of 0. So it means true has a value of 1 and false has a value of 0. Right, you don't need to get this true or false as a part of your as a result of your logical expression of Boolean expression. You can just type and see, just type true and just type false and see whether this true has a numerical value, right? Equal true plus 0, plus 0, answer must be 1. Yes. And false, yes, false has a numerical value. False plus 0, answer is 0. It means true has value of 1, false has a value of 0. This is not valid for other wordings. Let's say you say good and bad. Do you think you got the same answer? Let's say good plus 0. No, it's wrong. It's wrong. Right? And bad plus 0. Will you get 0? No. Is wrong, because these are just labels and no numerical values. But for this true and false has a unique value, standard value of 1 and 0, right? So this is very important. Second, we can use this concept in our formula writing. So we'll now see, based on this information, we will now see bonus calculation, right? Bonus calculation. We are now going to compute bonus for employees who have achieved their output more than 50 units. So accordingly, we'll write that condition. We'll first identify employees' right to bonus. Let's say employees' right to bonus, they will get true in front of their name. So how we can write the Boolean operator? So we can write our Boolean operations like this. Employees' output should be either greater than or equal to 50, enter, then true, then copy to all other people. Yes, so according you can see, employees who got true in front of their names, they are entitled to receive a bonus. If you have got false in front of your name, then you are not entitled to receive a bonus. So we'll now compute bonus by using this Boolean result. How can compute bonus? Bonus is equal, very simple, true times bonus. Because true has a value of 1, we know. You just enter and just copy. Okay. This time there's an error message. Why? We did not fix this cell. We'll fix this cell. Pressing F4. Just enter and okay, now you can see all the employees who got true in front of their names, they got bonus. We'll now compute gross salary. Gross salary is the sum of basic plus allowances. So gross salary is accordingly, basic is 100, we'll make fix, plus bonus. You can see, we can now compute gross salary, right? So accordingly, you can see the employees who got the bonus, their gross salary is 110. Employees with poor performance who are not entitled to receive bonus, their salary is just their basic salary, right? Now, we'll see how to compute gross salary without using all these columns. Is it possible to compute gross salary in one formula using Boolean operation? Yes, it is possible. It is possible, right? We'll write the formula like this. Equal, first check the condition, the cell value should be tested for whether it's greater than or equal 50, that is the threshold level. We'll open bracket. Right. If this condition satisfied, we can multiply this value. If this satisfies, you know, you got the answer true. If the answer is true, you can multiply this by bonus and we'll make it fixed. And to the, then this part, so far you compute the bonus only, then to the bonus you can plus basic salary and make it fixed. Close the bracket. If you no need to close the bracket, you just enter. You can see bonus is computed. Right, you can see it works. Right, we did not use we did not apply if function. Without using if function, we still managed to compute employees' gross salary, and we made a logical test. We tested employees' actual performance against the threshold level of 50, and we identified the employees who are entitled to receive bonus. And we finally managed to compute gross salary, right? Okay, so this is the application of Boolean operators, right? Now we are going to discuss how these Boolean operators are used or are applied with if function. And usually if functions can be applied in complicated scenario. So we will now discuss the application of if function in spreadsheet decision logics. Okay, we'll now accordingly move on to our next concept, application of if function in spreadsheet decision logics.